Hi, welcome to SOLIDWORKS 2020 video tutorial. In SOLIDWORKS, there's also an easy way to do such a kind of hexagon grill. Because, similar to Inventor, there is a vent command, which is very the same as the grill command, and there is a flex command, which is the same as the bend command. So, let's have some fun with SOLIDWORKS. Okay, let's start with a sketch on the front plane. I want to use a rectangle from the center, and this might be 250 by 150. Leave that sketch and make an extrude. Make it 2.5 millimeter and okay. Let's add some fillets or rounds. Fillet 10 millimeter is okay. Select the edges. Should be possible to select those hidden edges as well, but sometimes nope, that's wrong. Okay, and confirm. Now I will need another sketch and I will put this sketch onto that surface here. So go for another sketch on the surface, again a rectangle, and this should be 230 by 130. Let's add some fillets, 10 millimeters, yes. And confirm. And okay. Now I need the hexagons. Therefore, I will not use a polygon. I will do it in a different way. Let's look normal to this one. I need three lines. Maybe here. And another one here. Now I want to go for a 3-point arc, point, point, and point. This one should be centered, so you could snap here, possible, yes. And I need an angle of 120 once and twice. And that distance here should be 15. Not 115, but 15. Okay. The circle should be for construction only. Let's move this a little bit closer. Let's see if this moves correct. Yes, it does. Now I want to copy this one. Control C, Control V. This should be possible to move. Yes. And now those two points should be coincident. Okay, then I need a construction line from this point maybe to that point. Make it for construction. and this line and that center point should be coincident, and there should be a distance from this point to that point of maybe 150, 10 times 50 millimeter. Okay, and now I can make a linear pattern in my sketch. So I don't need those constraints. Let's see if I can deactivate the constraints here. Linear sketch pattern. Because if I pattern those constraints, I will get problems. So I might at least delete those 2/15s. In the sketch pattern, I want to pattern this line, that line, this line, this one, and that one. And in that direction, it should be 25.98. And in y direction, it should be, let's go for 11, it should be 15, and in that direction, it might be 12. Let's take a look. I can go for 11, yes, and that's okay. Yeah, so confirm. See, you've got all those constraints, even if I've deleted some. So let's select it. I know it's overdefined. This really takes some time. Yeah, that's kind of odd, but it is like it is. Still waiting. Okay, so I went for display relations and delete that pattern constraint here. Okay. Now I can trim, and before I could, of course, delete some elements. Of course, not that dimension. Okay. I could have used the filter. Now let's see if we can select those here. Delete them, go here and delete these, and now, I could delete those as well by selecting them carefully. Yep, and now I can do these as well. And now I have to trim. Let's zoom in a little bit. It's an easier way, but it's still time consuming. and you have to make sure everything is trimmed correct. This seems to be okay. Yeah. And confirm and close that sketch. And now I can go for the vent. Okay, let's use the vent. Search for it, select it. And if you select the complete sketch, it will automatically detect the boundary. So if you select this sketch, it will detect it and the previous activated, so you will see what will happen. Next, let's change the value of the rib to 1.1. I mean 1 millimeter depth and 1 millimeter wide. You could have an offset from the top. You have to make sure it's in the right direction, which is not very easy to see. So let's try, let's go for 1 millimeter, or let's say 1.5 millimeter offset, and select one rib, for example this one. And I see it's going above, so I have to turn it around so it will go down. Okay? And now you have to select all those ribs. And sadly, I was not able to figure out a way which allows me to select them sort of with a rectangle or a lasso. So you have to pick them one by one. Make sure you don't miss one, and you should deactivate the preview, because the preview will slow down the process very, very severely. So I will stop the recording and I will be back with all those ribs selected. So I've activated the preview and it seems I've got all my ribs selected. It really took a while. So if you have a faster machine, it will be considerably faster. Okay, so let's confirm. And again, it will take a while because those hexagons are really hard to calculate. But in the end, it will work. So see, it takes. So finally, it's done. Let's take a look. Looks good. Okay. Now for the two bends, we need the flex command. So let's look normal to that part. Search for the flex command. There it is. And go for bending and select the part. You will get this tool. And I want to go for, let's say, 20 degrees and the radius of 800. It will adjust automatically. So let's take a look. This will be bent in that direction. That's okay, because it doesn't really matter. The preview is very fast. But if you confirm, it will take again a while. Okay, the first bend is done, so let's go for a second one. Look normal to that object and go again for the flex. Select it. And that's the bend axis, so I want to turn this by 90 degrees. This looks okay, so it's minus 0, 0. So this should be 0. Okay. To 70 degree, that's, and this should be 180. Okay. Now let's go for 20 degrees and let's say 600. Again, the preview is very fast. So this seems to be in the wrong direction. Let's take a look. Or is it in the... It's bent in this direction and it's bent in that direction. Yeah, that's okay. So confirm. And again, it will take a while. And after waiting another while, it's done. Pretty nice and sort of easy, but you have to wait for a little while. Hope it was helpful. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did like it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook fan page. It would be very nice of you. I want to get more likes and subscriptions over there as well. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye-bye.